Awesome. Well, turn your Bibles to Luke chapter 10.
Okay, come on, bro.
I want to go through with us the heart of Bible Talk Expo.
Come on.
Why we do it, what it's for, what's a Bible Talk for?
Yep.
Why not just always have church service like four times a week?
Uh-oh.
Why do we have Bible Talks?
Okay.
In Luke chapter 10, beginning in verse 1, we're supposed to pass it while we say the prayer. So, amen. Luke chapter 10, verse 1. The Bible says, after this, the Lord appointed 72 others and sent them two by two ahead of him into every town and place where he was about to go.
Come on, bro.
He told them, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest field. He says, go. I'm sending you out like lambs among wolves. Do not take purse or bag or sandals, and do not greet anyone on the road. When you enter a house, first say peace to this house. If a man of peace is there, your peace will rest on him. If not, it will return to you. Going down to verse 17, after he sent them all out, the Bible says, the 72 returned with joy. And said, Lord, even the demons submit to us in your name. He replied, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome all of the power of the enemy. Nothing will harm you.
Come on.
He says, however, do not rejoice that all these things happen, but that your name is written in heaven. Amen. What we do as Bible Talks is what we do in being sent out.
Okay.
We're sent out like lambs amongst wolves. Yeah. And the Bible says that we're sent out ahead into all the places where Jesus will go, right?
Okay.
Let's be doing something here. So we've got people standing in the back, which is really bad because we have plenty of chairs for everyone.
Right.
So denominational seating makes people feel like there's not enough space for them.
Okay.
When we don't sit close. So moving forward, I'd like everybody, as you come in, don't sit in the back. Sit in the first row that's open, fill all the seats, and let's all fill up the front rows as we come in. Amen? I don't care what ministry you're in or whatnot or who's your best friend. We're all disciples.
Come on, bro.
And we all need to feel the love for one another. And we need, actually, denominational seating is very selfish.
Wow.
It gives no thought to those that are there, those who are planning. We have a whole second row here who's totally empty already. So if we all fill in those rows, then those who come in late already feeling bad will have a seat right open to be able to go right in and not feel as bad. Amen? So on a go forward, please don't just go up and sit in the back. Please come up as close as you can come. Okay? I mean, it's not a place of honor, but I need to be in this front row seat on this side every service. Why? I'm deaf in my right ear. So as everybody walks up and tries to talk to me, I have to be in this one so they can walk up and talk to me about service and different things that are happening. And I need to be able to come up and out. I don't feel like it's an honor, like it's my right. That's a logistical thing. If you care about me, then you want me to be able to run things.
Right.
In the same way, I care about every one of you that you'll come in and have a seat. Yeah. And if we're all together, then it makes that a whole lot better for everybody. Yeah. Amen?
Come on,
awesome. Awesome. Anyway, little side note. So the Bible Talks is where we're sent out. And as I was saying, we go to the place where Jesus is to go.
Okay.
All right? A Bible Talk is what we call a center of growth.
Okay?
We strategically try and plan where Bible Talks are going to be, and we plant it in that spot, and those people in that Bible Talk begin to evangelize their area around until more and more people in that area get evangelized. Then we plant other ones, and they begin to grow, and they begin to intersect and envelope evangelizing the whole area. Amen? So that's the purpose of why we do Bible Talks. It's our time to be sent out. And as that's sent out and it grows, guess who appears in that area? Where Jesus comes. And that area gets to have Jesus present. Is that not awesome? Turn to Philemon.
Come on, bro. Come on, bro. Come on, bro.
Philemon, verse 2. Verse 1. Paul, a prisoner of Christ Jesus, and Timothy, our brother. To Philemon, our dear friend and fellow worker. To Apphia, our sister. To Archippus, our fellow soldier. And to the church that meets in his home. That's pretty cranking.
Yeah, come on, bro.
We don't just meet for worship on Sunday. We meet together in homes throughout the week as well.
All right.
Amen? And so the whole purpose of having a Bible talk is this. So you look around the room. We've got 120 people in the room, right?
Come on. Okay.
I hate to tell you this, but I can't meet all 120 needs. I'm just a man who loves God and would give every fiber of my being. I go to bed at the wee hours of the night, up early all the time, to meet as many needs as I can meet.
Yeah.
But just like Jethro told Moses, no man can handle the strain of meeting all the needs of God's people. And so we delegate out the meeting of the needs.
Okay.
So a Bible talk is the most basic ministry where everyone in that group, their needs are met through the Bible talk.
On,
does that make sense?
Yeah.
And so that's the purpose of it. Now, you in and of yourself may or may not be able to meet all the needs of everyone in that group. And yet, here's the thing. Leading 5 people in a Bible talk or leading 5,000 people can be either awesome and a great experience, or it can be very challenging, depending on how you want to conduct yourself and the decisions that you make in leading that group, okay? And so that's why we have Bible Talk leaders meetings, okay? So in the Bible Talk leaders meetings is where we communicate all the things going in around through the church. So I run our region here, right?
Yeah.
I don't just, of my own accord, make my own plan for the region without any regard for Tim or what's happening in the church. Nor does Tim make his plan for the LA church without any regard for what's going on in the movement.
Come on.
There's a framework, there's a direction that provides a unity so that we all are moving the same direction
on,
as one
bro.
People. Amen?
And so
some of you could get a little more fired up about being unified worldwide level. I don't know what you've ever been a part of where you could be unified with people in other countries all over the planet.
It's beautiful.
It's a beautiful thing.
Amen.
And yet, when you go to a conference and you go and you see the disciples in Manila this year, you're going to come to find the same heart, the same spirit, the same love. You've got to understand that all the direction that creates that worldwide comes all the way down to the Bible talk level and has the same direction, the same goals, the same heart, the same purpose.
All right.
So we have Bible Talk leaders meetings on Sunday. That's where I, as the region leader, give all the direction of what's happening in the region. And so we give the direction and we give training, teaching you as Bible Talk leaders how to meet the needs of those people in your group. And it's not just meeting the needs. It's meeting the needs and being unified with the kingdom worldwide. That starts with being unified right here. Amen. And so if you're leading a Bible talk, it's very important that you show up. All your people will feel totally disconnected and totally out of the loop because you'll miss everything that's there.
Exactly.
Because if I had time to just go by person, tell every person the plan, hey, Princeton, here's what's going on. Joy, here's what's going on. We're not all together. How long would it take me to do that?
Yeah.
It'd take forever.
Yeah.
And so the Bible talk leaders meeting is where I can disseminate all the teaching and instruction from the scriptures, how to meet the needs of your brothers and sisters.
Come on.
In a denominational church, all the people have their needs, and they're not in each other's lives for the most part. But when they have needs, they go make an appointment with the minister.
Yeah.
And the minister may have one or two people else that he does.
Yeah.
Hundreds or thousands of people. You think their needs get met like that? No, they don't get met like that. It's not the minister's job to meet all the needs of the church.
Right.
It's the smallest group leader's jobs to meet the needs of those people in their group.
Yeah.
And then to bring the ones that are difficult to the leaders above them.
Nice.
So because of that, we group the Bible talks into what we call house churches.
Oh, wow.
Okay?
Amen. Okay.
And so our house churches this year are, give me your names.
Wow.
So James and Jennifer Haynes, stand up. And the name of your house church is?
The Rocksteady House Church.
And then also we have in Hawthorne area, Princeton and Joy George leading house church. Right?
We're going to stay the same. We're going to stay the same.
pastor. All right. And then we're trying to solidify totally with the Latin ministry, but why don't Hector and Wendy and Mario and Bertha stand up.
Come on.
These are our leaders of the Latin ministry. Amen. And so, but here's the thing. So I teach and train those individuals to meet the needs. They, in turn, are going to teach and train their people how to meet their needs. That's why we have discipling times,
Amen.
Where we learn to obey everything Jesus commanded.
Amen.
So the schedule of the church is communicated at Bible Talk leaders' meetings. The teaching of the unity of God's people is taught at the Bible Talk leaders' meetings.
Amen.
Now, here's the thing. Do you want stale Bible Talks that never grow? Or do you want awesome, incredible, vibrant Bible Talks that are fruitful? Right? So there's this, the doggonedest thing that happens when you have a fruitful Bible Talk. It gets too big for the house it's meeting in. You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
So then what happens? Then it's got to split into two groups.
Okay.
So Bible Talk leaders are not just taking care of the needs of the people in the group. They also have an assistant. Who at any moment can handle everything happening in the Bible Talk. And what they're doing is they're training so that when the Bible Talk grows and gets big enough, it splits. Now, who's going to lead the other one? The assistant. Now, if you're wise, the moment you begin leading a Bible Talk, you figure out. Now, you don't figure out who you like most.
Right?
Right? You don't do it that way.
Nope.
You figure out who's the most faithful, reliable person that you have.
Amen.
All right?
Amen.
That's how you figure it out. You don't have to like them. You don't have to whatever. I mean, you do or you won't go to heaven. But
but
it doesn't have to be who you like most. It's who's going to be most reliable, right? Who's going to be there all the time? Who can carry out instructions? And who can just talk in front of people a little bit? And you grab that person right from the beginning, and you involve them in everything you're doing in the Bible Talk. Now, a car wipes you out on the way to Bible Talk. They're going to show up, and they're going to do Bible Talk. Then they'll go to your funeral afterwards.
That's it.
Yeah. No, I'm just kidding. No, when you get sick or you have a challenge, they're your person you lean on. You divide the work equally between you in the Bible Talk while it's happening.
Okay.
You give them first shot at the hard case that's happening.
Oh, yeah.
Then you come in after that, and because you're learning the same thing in Bible Talk leaders meeting and how to teach and train people, you're teaching that person the same scriptures one after another, and they're seeing the unity of our teaching and our convictions.
Amen.
And so then when it splits, then there isn't chaos.
Yep.
Then people aren't running around feeling like they don't have a leader,
right,
because they already have two, and they'll naturally go to both. Then if there's a challenge, then the house church leader will take that to the Bible Talk leader will take those challenges to their house church leaders. You know who they are now. And so tonight's purpose is that everybody knows what the Bible Talks are.
Yeah.
Everybody knows the geographic area of that center of growth. And everyone knows the goals for the new year. Amen? So for the Crew Super Region, for the AMS, and for the Southland, we have the theme of having the best year of your life in 2017. All right? That's our super regional theme. Now, the theme church-wide is the year of the impossible. And so that's incredible. Because what that means is, you know, can you kind of see how those fit together? Because when you're going to do things that you thought were impossible, you're doing them because you're having the best year of your life. You see what I'm saying? And so in that same way, you see how my thinking, we get the theme for the church, and I go, what theme would be awesome and motivating that fits within the framework of what my leaders are planning so we all stay unified? I don't really go outside the framework. Am I free to? Yes. But I don't. Why? So we stay unified and stay tied in and feel a part of the movement, feel a part of the church. Amen? So with that, tonight, what we're going to do is after I'm done here in a minute or so, then we're going to take a fellowship break. I'm going to let each of your house churches get together and just finalize your plans. So what we're going to do after that is we're going to have our expo. So each Bible Talk is going to come on up, right? The house church leaders will start. They'll start introducing their house church and their own personal Bible Talk. And then one by one, each Bible Talk will come up. So what you're going to give is you're going to give the name of your Bible Talk. Amen. We all want to know the names. And I need a volunteer that can write them all down for me. I need a volunteer that can write them all down. So Janelle, thank you. Awesome. So you'll state the name of your Bible Talk, the area for where you're going for. We don't want you to focus on all of LA. That would be overwhelming, right? So you focus on the people that are successful evangelize where they live,
right?
They don't travel across the city because they like the people on the other side of the city more,
right. And
then can never get visitors to go all the way across the city with them.
Right.
They evangelize where they live,
yeah. And
they get along with whoever is in that area by them and know God put those disciples around them. Amen?
Okay.
That's what mature disciples do, and that's why they become effective. So you'll say your area of growth, and then you'll state your goals for your Bible talk.
All right.
And you may have a chant, you may have whatever, you know, I can't wait to see all of it. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is we'll start out first. The Haynes will get up with their house church, and everybody line up on this side.
Yeah.
So first, the Haynes house church will all line up one Bible talk at a time, and then you'll come up one by one. When we get to the last Bible talk, then brothers and sisters in the Latin ministry, you guys line up, and you'll line up Bible talk by Bible talk and come up. And then the Wow House church with Princeton and Joy, when the third Bible talk from the Latin ministry goes up, you guys will come on up, and you circle this way. So come in this way and circle back out this way. And, you know, this is going to provide evangelization here in South Central. Amen. These are not autonomous, but these are individual little churches that meet in people's homes, that meet each other's needs, that teach each other to obey everything, that evangelize together, live together, have great times together, that operate like a family and mobilize like an army when the time is appropriate. So that's what we're all about tonight.
Nice.
Let's take a 5-minute break, organize everyone, and come back with fire. Amen. Love you guys.
All right. Well, I want to, so everybody, let's go ahead and get up and line on up. The Rock City House Church, go ahead. All right, well, I want to bring up the real zeal Bible talk first. But first of all, I want to talk about the Rocksteady House Church. You know, when I came here, I saw that this group of people, they were doing an incredible job, the Incredibles, and that they were relying on Christ as King. And every day they were denying themselves. And I was like, man, that sounds like a Rocksteady group. And when you take the acronym of Rock Steady,
okay.
Rock stands rely on Christ as King.
Oh.
Steady says stay true every day, always denying yourself. And we're the Rock Steady House Church. So come on up. And in the Rock Steady House Church, we got the pace setting Bible talk of the real zeal. So we have the real zeal Bible talk. Let's come on and pull it all the way around, all the way around. So it's led by me and my wife, James and Jennifer Haynes, Robert and Patricia Coble. Then we have D'Shay right over here, Gloria White over there. Then we have Miss Wazira right here, man. We gotta take care of the wisdom of the group right there. Then we have Bernicia right here. And we're supposed to have our honorary member right over here, Edgar. He's an honorary member for today. But we're the Real Zeal Bible Talk. We got a little chant that goes like this.
Okay,
rock to the east with real zeal. Rock to the west with real zeal. Rock to Jesus, real zeal. Rock to the best, real zeal. Down the alley, real zeal. Hear our cry with real zeal. Think you can beat us, real zeal. Welcome to try, real zeal. Got the coaches. Real zeal. Got the team.
Real zeal.
In the movement. Real zeal. You know what I mean? With real zeal. So, with real zeal, our number one goal in our group is for every member to break through a stronghold that is stopping us from struggling to be, to have our excellent walk with God. So everybody has a stronghold, something that's holding them back. But our number one, as our group, our number one goal is to break through whatever stronghold, whatever it is that's stopping us from being the best we can for God. That's our number one goal. And in 2 Corinthians 10, verse 3 through 6, it says, let me take them off. For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with, are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds.
Yeah. Come
We demolish every argument that sets it and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God. Yes. And we take captive every thought and make it obedient to God.
That's right.
And that's our theme scripture for our group. Our second goal, there we go, is for everybody to read a book.
Okay.
It's either The Victory of Surrender,
yeah.
It Doesn't Feel Like Love, and The Lion Never Sleeps, and use that to really help them get through whatever stronghold that they're, and we're going to discuss this as a group to really, you know, get the right book for the right situation.
Yeah.
Our third goal is to have 6 editions by June,
okay.
3 men and 3 women,
yeah.
You know, so 6 editions by June. Our fourth goal is to plant a Bible Talk in Lenox, which is right, that's right, that's part of, you know, there's a little Englewood's little brother down there in the little corner. To plant a little Bible Talk right in there. And then our fifth goal is to plant a second Bible Talk that comes from here this year by the next Expo.
Yeah.
So, and we're going to do all that with real zeal. Amen.
Good night, church. Good night, church. I'd like to introduce you to my co-leader, Janet. To the left of Janet, we have Tony. We have Lethe. Ariel to my right. Johnny. His wife Janae, she wasn't feeling well, so she had to leave. My right hand, Ricky. And Karen.
Good evening. I would like you guys to turn your Bibles to Psalms 107, Scriptures 10 through 16.
Some sat in the dark and the deepest gloom, prisoners suffering in iron chains.
For they rebelled against the words of God and despised the counsel of the Most High.
So he subjected them to bitter labor, and they stumbled, and there was no one to help.
Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them from their distress.
He brought them out of darkness and the deepest gloom and broke away their chains.
Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for men.
For he breaks down gates of bronze and cuts through bars of iron. Let's break the chains in our lives and help others break the chains in theirs. We are the
Chain Breakers Bible Talk.
All right, like I said, we're the Chain Breakers Bible Talk. Our geographic area is Englewood. Our Bible Talk goals are to grow as a Bible Talk. Baptize more men. Have quiet times with each other every week. That's our second goal. Our third goal is
come on, bro.
Give me a minute. Oh. All right, baptize a family member. And, um, Another one is getting each other lives daily so we could get more open. And those are our goals.
Get in tight. All right, so how's everyone doing tonight? Woo! Yes. Awesome. I'm so grateful to be up here right now and be a part of this exciting experience. Give me a sec. So I'm going to start off by reading a scripture, then I'm going to go ahead and introduce everyone. So in Psalms 102, verse 16 through 18. The Bible reads, if I can see it, okay. For the Lord will rebuild Zion and appear in his glory. He will respond to the prayers of the destitute. He will not despise their plea. Let this be written for a future generation, that a people not yet created may praise the Lord. And we are that generation. So without further ado, I give to you the ITG
In This Generation
Bible Talk. So to my right, far right over here, we have the lovely Bonita Holmes. Yes. And right next to her, we have Mr. Suave himself, the smooth Alan Young. All right. Then we have our brother of encouragement, Calvin Fletcher Rush. Or Fulcher, I'm sorry. All right. Then to our far left, I'm sorry. We have our brother visiting from the IE region, Dwayne. Then right next to Dwayne, we have our awesome sister, BB. All right. And my lovely sister right here, Alicia Jones. Yes. And last but not least, my amazing co-leader, Alice Brewer. Yes. And I am Richard Cato. So, So here's our goals going into the new year, and this is more of a church house goal, going after demolishing one stronghold. This is the Rock Steady Bible Talks, household goal, to make sure that each and every one of us pinpoint something in our life that we just destroy going into the next year, right? Read a book apart from the Bible. Right now I'm reading this book called Guilty Souls to Grace. Me, it's really helped me a lot to just be, sometimes we can beat ourselves up as time goes on and things like that, but it's really helping me grow and learning to just accept God's grace and his love, right? Have 6 additions to our house church by June, right? So we definitely want to add some people to our church as well. And then going forward, splitting our Bible talk as well by April, right? Also, we want to have, going into the New Year's, some male and female baptism within either the end of the month or going into the New Year's of January. And to become a force that is unified mind, body, and soul, right? That is something super important. I believe that unity is so powerful. And as a church, and just as people, if we learn to just be unified and really just come together and work for God, that he will be able to do powerful things through us. I got a couple right here. To embody the fruits of the spirits, Galatians 5:22, right? And last but not least, become prayer partners, become really strong in our prayer, and just pray that God just bless our efforts. So, with that, guys, we give to you ITG once again In This Generation Bible Talk. We love you. Thank you so much. All right.
Good evening, church. I have the privilege and honor of co-leading the Special Ops Bible Talk with my amazing partner, Anthony Johnson, that's not here tonight. I'd like to introduce you the women of the Special Ops Bible Talk. We have Esther Voltaire. We have Candace Monroe. We have Leela Jackson. Myself, Montserrat Perez. And we have three women that couldn't make it tonight. We have Destiny Pickett, Josephine. Yeah, well, she can be up here. Josephine Milwaukee, and we also have Phoebe Meza, which is at home. She's got some food poisoning. But I'd love to share a scripture, which is the stream scripture for our Bible talk. It is in Romans 10. If you would turn with that there to me with that, verse 12 through 15. It says, "For there is no difference between Jew and Gentile. The same Lord is Lord of all and richly blesses all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. How then can they call on the one who they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can anyone preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news." So this is the theme scripture of our Bible talk. We are on a special operation to evangelize our area. Amen. We our geographical area is from Slauson La Brea down to the Ladera Center, which is in Ladera Heights. We, in unity with our house church, we are also going after actively breaking one stronghold individually so that we can help break those chains for 2017. Our goal is to add three men to our Bible talk, so that would be multiplying the number of men that we have in our Bible talk. We'll also be reading Secure in Love so that the women in the Bible talk get very confident and get their identity through Christ, and therefore be helpful to the men in our Bible talk. And our goal is to split by March. Amen. So thanks for your time. And that was all.
Special ops roll out.
We rolling out.
POD. 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 All right. Woo. As you notice, we are POD, and that means place of discipleship. You grow here, you will grow here, or you will go. I don't know, but amen. No, you will grow here, you will love here, and we'll be family here. But before I introduce the men, I want Vontae to introduce the women. Amen.
So I want to introduce y'all to my amazing women. We got Takara in the building. We got Keyshara in the building. We got Yayeezy, Yaya in the building. We got Alicia in the building. We got Vicky in the house. And last but not least, my right hand, Nikki Smoke. And these are my words of movement. Amen.
Well, I got some amazing men. All right, we got Kevin, the enforcer, the sound, the encourager. We got Randall, love bomb, always loving, always Facebooking love, White. All right, so right now, place, you know what? I believe that children is part of the Bible talk. I do not put children in the room. We got Marshawn in the Bible talk. So the goal, let's go to Revelation 3:21. Let's go to Revelation. I'm fired up about my group. I hope you are too. They're amazing. They're beautiful. They're encouraging. So in Revelation 3:21, to the one who is victorious, I will give the right to sit with me on my throne, just as I was victorious and sat down with my Father on the throne. This year, for our Bible talk, we will be victorious in West Adams. And West Adams has 21,918 young men and young women that are lost. So we are going after it. I don't care if it's going to be a house church and someone else take over it. I don't care. But we are going after each individual person, attacking them, attacking the demons, and inviting them into Alicia's home. But you say, but you say, how in the world is Jermaine going to do that with no education? Oh, okay, well, lack of degree. But Luke 18:37, my Bible says, with God it's possible. With man, this is not possible. So by faith, in June, we'll have 20 baptisms. You see this right here? Majority is women. They're talented, right? Why not have a lot of men in Bible talk? All they got to do is open their mouth. Hey, come to Bible talk. They look good. They're going to come to Bible talk, and we're going to baptize the men. Because my short-term goal is to multiply more men in our Bible talk. And all I got to say is this. When you love as family, you'll be fruitful. But when you're dysfunctional as family, you won't grow. But we're going to be functional as family, and we're going to grow. Let's go. POD.
Hold it down.
Yeah, that's it. All right, you guys. So we in here are going to be leading these amazing people in here, which is the Latin ministry here. You might say, well, our Bible talk is going to focus on this area or that city and everything. But let me tell you, we're going to be in your town. We're going to be in your neighborhood. We're going to be in your barrios, too, to be able to evangelize these people. Amen. So with this, I have this scripture in here in John 10:3. And it says, the gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. So when he has brought out all of his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. So as a ministry here, we're going to listen to Jesus' voice. So he's the one who's going to lead us, and we're going to make sure that everyone is listening to God's voice and Jesus Christ. So with this, I introduce you guys the first Bible talk in here. Come on, Alex. And he'll tell us.
What's up, family? How y'all doing? So I want to just start off by reading the scripture. It's in Romans 6, verse 17 through 18. It says, thank God. It says, once you were slaves of sin, but now you wholeheartedly obey this teachings we have given you. Now you are free from your slavery to sin, and you have become slaves to the righteous living. That's right. I read this scripture because our name, you know, we're Spanish, so we're S-A-L, which means somos almas libres, which means we are free souls. And I'm excited because, you know, the Latin ministry has been teaching me a lot, with my brother Mario right here, about helping me out. And in our Bible talk, we include with me, Alex, brother Lupe right here. We have two sisters. It's Cynthia. She's not right here right now. She's sick. Please pray for her health. As well as Mario's aunt, Beatriz. She's in the hospital. Something had happened. But please pray for them. You know, let God over, just protect them and watch over them. And our goal for our mission, oh, and as well, we're going to be being shepherded by the Ibarros right here. So please pray for them for leadership. Overall, our goal is really just to, like, of course, you know, to be the best disciples as we can be, you know, really be fruitful. But our main goal, you know, God willing, faithfully, we put in, you know, the work, is to grow every month by 2 members. Rather baptisms, rather restorations, add-ons, whatever it is. But we're going to grow. So by the end of this year, by the end of 2017, we'll split into 2 more Bible talks. Our designated areas, like my brother said right here, you know, we all live in different cities. So like he said, we're going to be everywhere. You know, we might even be in your Bible talk one time. You know, you never know. You know what I mean? But please pray for us. Really just, you know, give us your support and all that stuff. And I love you all.
Good evening, church. How you guys doing? So we have the opportunity to introduce to you guys los servidores, the servants of Christ. So we want to share a scripture with you. And it's in John.
Vamos, Hector.
Come on, bro.
John 12:26. It says, whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, my servant also will be. My Father will honor the one who serves me. So we are going to serve our Lord Jesus Christ by spreading the truth about him in the land community of Compton. And then right now, I just want to introduce to you guys our Bible talk. I'm going to start off with my wonderful wife, Wendy. And next, the new Sanchez's. Got my brother Andres as my co-lead, and then the wonderful sister Bridget. And then also, you know, just to mention, we do have the moms with us, Dolores and Maria. They're just not here with us right now, but keep them in your prayers as well. And then I'm gonna go ahead and introduce to you Andres. He's gonna do it in Spanish for us.
Yeah. Buenas noches, hermanos y hermanas. Les traigo la palabra de Dios esta noche. Y tengo una escritura para ustedes en el libro de Juan. La palabra dice, quien quiera servirme debe seguirme, y donde yo esté, ahí también estará mi siervo. Y a quien me sirva, mi Padre lo honrará. Y con eso decirles, les quiero decir que nuestro llamado en esta ciudad de Compton va a ser predicar a todas las familias latinas y en la comunidad y ayudar a toda la gente que está perdido en este mundo. Y con eso los quiero decir que todo se puede con Dios y nosotros somos los servidores de Cristo.
Good evening, church. All right. First of all, the name of our Bible talk name is Bethel. Yeah. That means the house of God. And we got that for an inscription, so you can find that in Genesis 28:19. All right. My beautiful wife, Lucy, right here, and my two little kids. Okay, and I have like a co-leader, Juan Lunas. Juan Lunas, and his wife Eunice Lunas. And we still have our amazing brothers, Johnny and Beto. And they're 5 beautiful kids, and they're 2 beautiful kids. We have a lot of kids. Okay, so I'll leave you with Juan. He's going to share a scripture for you guys. So you can look at Jeremiah 29:11.
Hello, family. Good night. Yeah.
There's a scripture I want to share with you guys tonight, and it's in Jeremiah 29:11. So everybody knows that scripture already? For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, your plans to give you and hope in a future. So our brother Johnny will share for us for the goals for 2017 for tonight.
I don't know about everybody else, but me, I am fired up, because what a better plan to put a Spanish ministry in the city of Watts. I mean, that's just fired up. So our goal is to evangelize every corner in the city of Watts. And to do that, we got to be bold as lions and charging as bears. Oh, yeah. Our goal is to baptize 2 family members and to share every corner, I mean, to continue to grow our family ministry with our children, of course. Amen. 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 Our brother Rudy's going to continue.
All right, so that's an amazing Bible talk. And like I said, we have God in our side. God is with us. So everything we can do, like we read in Jeremiah 29, we can do everything. And he has a better future for us, or a better future forever. It's outside lost. We are here to get everybody in and help everybody that is waiting for us to go outside there and help them. And let's not stay quiet. Let's open our mouths so we can get more and more every day. All right, we can do this with God. Bethel!
Hey man, well, it's good to be with the Southland region. Hey man, I do want to give it up for the Rock Steady House Church. Hey man, bro, you guys are going to do amazing things. But my wife and I, Joy, we're here on behalf of the Wild House Church, amen. And Mason and Natalie, we're so grateful to serve you guys and to take over. They named the Wild House Church after an acronym, amen. It stands for Walking on Water. And if you guys take a look at that group right there, that is a group that's going to walk on water in the year of 2017, amen. And our geographic area is the South Bay area of Los Angeles. Amen. Make some noise if I have Hawthorne in the house. Make some noise if we got Torrance in the house. At least the north part right there. Amen. Make some noise if we got Compton, Paramount in the house right there. Just a little bit. Amen. And we don't want to bleed into the Rock Steady because they got Inglewood on lock. Amen. With that said, I do want to share a quick scripture here, Mark chapter 10. And I think it sets up the theme of the year for us as a house church. I believe with all my heart, Joy and I believe that God can do the impossible through us if we only believe. Mark 10, verse 27. Jesus looked at them and said, "With man, this is impossible, but not with God. All things are possible with God." And we have one simple goal and theme of the year, and that is to double as a house church. Amen. That's the double. I believe that if every disciple goes and does what was done for them, essentially, and baptize one individual, we'll double in numeric growth. If every Bible talk sets out to double as a Bible talk, we'll stand here next year and we'll be twice the size we are. And I believe that it's a scary goal. I even share with them, I haven't been, quote unquote, personally fruitful in a while. So for me, I can look at this goal, and even the goal of just grabbing one individual can seem impossible. You guys with me here? And so I go, that's my goal. And that's the theme for the house church. So I pray you guys are with me. I'm with you guys, heart and soul. We're going to go and grab one person and do what was done for us. With that said, I do want to lift up the Bible Talk leaders and the house churches. I'd like to bring up the campus and the teens up first.
Come on.
Well, amen, guys. I am fired up. Acts 1,
verse 8 says, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Amen. With that being said, we got power house. Y'all hear that? Y'all hear that? Let's do it again. We got power house. All right now. All right now. So obviously we are on El Camino, but we want to grow. We want to grow, amen. So before that, I want to introduce everybody here. I want everybody. So we got the sweetheart, Miss Brittany. We got Ashanti in the house. Come on.
That's my little sister.
We got the little homie, Carla. Then we got my boy who just got baptized, Sam. Well, he's not new, but he's not old. We got my man, Kid of the Hammer Woods. And then my amazing, amazing co-leader, Talisha. Come on, guys. Our goal is to double. We want to change El Camino. We want to be the heartbeat of El Camino. But we don't want to just double and stay there, right? That'd be weird, right? We want to double, and we want to go to El Camino Compton.
Come on.
We want to go to Southwest. And we want to double in those ministries as well. So, with that being said, guys, amen.
Amen, everyone. My name's Rico Jones, alongside my amazing wife, Janelle Jones. I got a scripture for you guys to introduce our Bible talk. It's in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 22. You were taught with regard to your former way of life to put off your old self, which is being corrupted by its deceitful desires, to be made new in the attitude of your minds, and to put on the new self, created to be like God in true righteousness and holiness. We are ground. So,
No more time. We're here. One. Okay.
And we put on the new self, created to be like God in true righteousness and holiness. We are ground.
So
of course our geographical area of attack is of course the El Camino campus, But we just like the Powerhouse Bible Talk, we have ambitions to go to a different campus. Our campus of interest is the West Los Angeles Community College. And so that's our goal. But for those of you who don't know, this is my awesome wife, Janelle Jones, of course. In our Bible talk, we have Keontae. Ooh, nice hat. We got Trey. We got Tio. And of course, we have Princess. And so next year for 2017, guys, our goals are simple. We plan on splitting the Bible talk. That means raising up someone to lead that Bible talk. And so that's our plan is to split the Bible talk. But at the same time, our desire and our goal is for each one of us to be personally fruitful and to really grow the campus ministry in an amazing way. So pray for us, guys. We love you guys with all our heart. Amen. Guys, I bring you greetings. My name is Rico Jones. It's my amazing wife, Janelle Jones. And I have an encouraging scripture for you guys to introduce our Bible talk. It's in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 1. As a prisoner for the Lord, then I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you have received. I bring you greetings from the Teen Mobile Ministry. Hello! Guys, so in the amazing Teen Mobile Ministry, of course, for the ladies, we have Miriam! We have Nidia! Oh, Also, we have Nancy and Cassandra Garcia, who are not here tonight, but they're awesome. For the gentlemen, we got Dylan. We got Joshua. Josiah. And of course, Ethan as well. Our area of attack is the Legacy High School.
Amen.
Of course, it's amazing, as well as the Redondo Union High School.
Amen.
Our goal for 2017 is, again, simple and yet I think profound. We've decided to put on our hearts to double this ministry, but not in a simple way. Nah. Our goal is to baptize 4 kingdom kids. Oh! 4 kingdom kids. So if you got kids, bring them to me. 4 kingdom kids. But at the same time, our goal is to also baptize 4 non-kingdom kids, kids out there at either in Legacy High School or in Redondo Union. And so, guys, this has been the Teen Mobile Ministry, and we love you guys with all our hearts. God bless. Yeah!
All right, guys. All right, good evening. So my name is Alejandro Pinedo, but you guys can call me AJ. And of course, this is Cheryl Lynn Pinedo. And you guys know her as CL. Now, please turn your Bibles to Luke 17, starting in verse 10. So you also, when you have done everything you were told to do, shall say, we are unworthy servants. We have only done our duty. So I would like to introduce you to the Call of Duty Bible Talk. Woo! So with that, first most, I would like to introduce you to Chris and Charlotte Anderson. And obviously, Jada and Jair. Please give them a chair. Come on.
And we also have Brian and Anna Ramirez with their 4 kids, Anna Jr., Destiny and Jonah. They're not here right now, but they're awesome.
Now, and last, I also want to introduce you to Nate, the pure-hearted Nate. And of course, least and probably not the least, Rosie. Rosie is our... So with that, I would like to introduce you to our goals. So our goals is simple, is to double by June and be personally fruitful. And obviously, since we're married, Bible talk, except for Nate, is to actually is to strengthen our marriages and be and multiply Nate, obviously, into another pure soul. And our territory is the South Bay sector, specifically Hawthorne. And with that, Call of Duty Bible talk. Ahoo! Ahoo!
Well, I would definitely like to introduce you to the deeply rooted Bible talk. Well, I definitely have a scripture for you, our theme scripture. It's in Colossians 2, starting verse 6. It says, so then, just as you receive Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live in him, rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness.
Go ahead, Noel.
With that, we have another brother who's going to be deeply rooted in his faith. We have Matt Hall. He just became a dad. My wife is going to introduce the women.
Okay, we've got some amazing women here. We've got Julie. She's such a great servant. Every time you have communion, it's Julie putting together communion for us. We've got Judy. Super faithful, won over her son.
Oh yeah.
Amen. We've got Cindy. You ever want to be encouraged? Talk to Cindy. We've got Lisa. She's got amazing wisdom, very loving. Talk to her as well.
But definitely I want you guys to be encouraged. Our goal this year, just as the group, is to double. But it's to double in our faith, to double in our love, to double in our deeds, and to double in number. So that's why we want to be deeply rooted in every area so that we all can be strong for Christ. Amen. And that's where I go.
I'm sorry, we have Nave who is feeding the baby.
It's a neighborly day in this beauty wood, and a neighborly day for beauty. Would you be mine? Would you be mine?
Yo, what's going on, family? Yeah, bring it up!
You guys, this is our family right here. We are the neighbors of the Thorn. Our area evangelization is obviously Hawthorne. This is the magnificent Magdaleno Mayorga. Cynthia Martinez, my lovely co-leader, my wife, Carol. The Bejaranos, Omar and Ashley. Our kids, this is Kaylee and Angel and Melanie. So our goal for our Bible talk this year is for... baptize a married couple and also one single and single woman and man. And yeah, that's basically it, man. Yeah, so thank you.
That's right.
Amen. Well, I bring you the last Bible talk of the Wow House Church. Amen. And very excitingly, when people leave, there's room for opportunity and growth, amen? Room for people to step up. And with that said, I'm very excited because our dear sister Erica and our brother Moses, he's not here right now. He's on away Christmas break here, but they're stepping up to lead a Bible talk. And very excitingly, they have titled their Bible talk, Gravity. Now, I'm sure they're going to stay grounded for the Lord, amen. And they'll come up with a cool chant later. I'll leave that to Moses and Erica. With that said, Erica will be co-leading with Moses. We have the lovely Ashley in our Bible talk as well. Our dear brother Abel is coming on over to Hawthorne, amen. He was in AJ and CL's Bible talk, but he's moving over to Hawthorne and will probably host Bible talk in his new home, amen. And... I'm very excited. With that said, their goal is the same as the house church. They want to double in numeric number and spiritually as well. Amen. Let's give it up for the Gravity Bible Talk.
Okay, well, was that awesome or what? All right. You got Jermaine level 10. We got to add a level. We got to add a level for Jermaine, man. It's awesome. Well, I just want to close this out with a few announcements and some things about the new year here. Just so you guys know, this year we added 74 people to the region, amen? Which is incredible. And we had almost 40 people go out of the region. But because we added so many people, it wasn't a huge shrinkage like everybody thought was going to happen. So I want to commend everybody for all your hard work in making that happen. That's awesome. My goals for the region as a whole are pretty straightforward. Amen. My goal is, now the church goal is that every region has at least 100 baptisms this year. Amen. That's the goal that Tim has set for the church. I think that would be lukewarm for us. Yeah. We're mobilized, we're organized, yeah. And we've got some great leadership in place, yeah. And we don't have tons of people moving out like we had this year. Yeah. We had nearly weekly baptisms. If we were to have two more baptisms in the last 2 weeks, we would actually have weekly baptisms for the year. Wow. No other region even came close to that. We had the most transition, and we don't have the most baptisms, but we are right there at the top of the list with everybody. That is phenomenal. That's not a testimony to us. We came in and we've got a great group with all of you guys. That's a testimony to all your faith. But my goal is that we have 150 additions this year in this region. But I have a caveat to that goal. Growth does not sell everything about a church.
No, man.
Amen. Nope. My goal is that we have 150 additions that come from our faith and our gratitude for our salvation. Yeah. Amen. People that are baptized because the leader wants a number don't stay faithful in the end. Exactly. And they're not made into real disciples. Exactly. My goal is that we add 150 disciples to this region. Yeah. Amen. My second goal is for everyone's spiritual growth. Without spiritual growth, you will not have the best year of your life. My goal for every individual, every single one of you, is that you take your deepest character flaw and that you have victory over that character flaw in 2017. We all have one. My goal is that we all overcome our biggest one. Then it's smooth sailing through all the rest of them, amen? My third goal is that each one of us read through the entire Bible in 2017. Amen? We've got to be a church that knows our Bible and is deep in Scripture and is led. We cannot be led by the voice of God unless we listen to the voice of God from Scripture. Amen? And so, the fourth goal is that we double the number of Bible talks that we have in our region.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because if we just grow and we don't grow the number of Bible talks, we will incur many fallaways.
Yeah.
I don't like fallaways.
Yeah.
I don't like baptizing somebody and going through the agony of them walking away.
Yeah, come on.
And we had way too many of those this year.
Yeah.
My goal is that we are able to keep people faithful. And we've got to understand, you Bible talk leaders have to understand, if you don't have a leader set by the time you need to split, you're going to lose people in that split.
Right.
And so my goal is that we add double the number of Bible talks, which means we have double the number of leaders at the end of the year to take care of these people so that we don't have losses in the middle of it. Amen?
Yeah.
Awesome. So with that, as of now, just so all of you know, as of now, the whole LA staff is on Christmas vacation through the end of the year. And so what that means is that that just means we're on vacation. So what does vacation look like for a ministry person?
Yeah.
Well, today I think I took 34 phone calls,
right,
and I answered about 70 emails, and I was working all the way up until I got here.
Right.
So that's vacation.
Yep.
So a lot of people go away on vacation. We just don't have the money to go away. So my vacation is going to be at my house right here. Now, here's the thing. From now until then, I'm not going anywhere, so which means I'm not coming to your house. But my house is wide open, okay? My house is wide open. So what we're doing for vacation is every night we are watching movies.
Every night.
Every night. We're having dinner and we're watching movies. And any of you that want to come watch movies with us, this is the time we don't want to take a rest from you. We want to rest with you. Okay? So I'm not going to set up plans one or another. We're not going to have any D times until after the first of the year. But we're at our home every night, and you can count on that. And so, for sure, Tracy may drive the kids somewhere. I'm not going anywhere. So I'm just resting. I'm resting and watching movies. Come watch movies with me, and we'll be family together through the holidays in that way. Amen? Now, when the new year starts, there's some things that we need to understand. So, the new year celebrations, I'd like it if maybe one of the groups that doesn't have a place yet for the new year celebration did it at my house. So we have enough to have a celebration with about 35 people. So we'd like to have one of the groups over. What Tracy and I are going to begin to do, we're not leading a specific Bible talk right now, because now we don't just have Southland, we have AMS. We have double the number of people that we oversee. So what we're going to be doing is having different Bible talks over to our home to spend time with each of you. It's very important to us that we are able to connect and spend time with each of you. And so the way we're going to do that is we're going to have you not have a Bible talk for one of your Bible talks and come to our home and have a night where we just talk about our lives And you get to know us. We'll tell our life story. You guys tell yours. And we'll really get to know each other as family so that we can really be there for each other in the tough times. Okay. Amen? So one by one, we'll just start meeting with each of the Bible talks, one week at a time. We might do two a week if we can handle doing that. But once we do that, then you find out issues, and then you got to help people through the issues. So we may just do one a week. So that's going to be our pattern until we ensure all the groups are strong, that we all know each other, that we really have family in each of the groups, so that the groups can move forward. Amen? My goal is that you guys can run everything in your Bible talk and take care of all of your needs without me present. Great leadership is not when the leader is there. We don't have Pastor Bobs that do everything and run themselves ragged and die of a heart attack because they're just doing everything. Great leadership is teaching you to function and have a healthy group without us present. It's to engage until you can do that on your own and be multiplying on your own and then disengage and go to help the next group do that. So we're going to go Bible talk by Bible talk through the whole region, helping until that's the case. Okay. You'll be much more happy when you're a vibrant, fruitful, growing Bible talk and you're doing it on your own. That's awesome. Now, when the new year starts, we will have our winter workshop. So our winter workshop starts, for us, it starts on January 3rd, Tracy and I. And we have meetings at the Pasadena Hilton. On the 6th is our Bible Talk workshop. And so the Bible Talk workshop costs $25. So I know some of you may not be able to do that. That's fine. We will record it. It's where we're at financially. Yep. So as we get better financially, then those things will change as we go along. But then on the 7th, we will be all together. And that will be at the Pasadena Convention Center. Okay, that's just right up the street from the Hilton. So that starts at 9 a.m. The singing starts at 9 a.m. So you don't want to arrive at 9 a.m. You want to arrive, have your seat, and start fellowshipping at 8:30 a.m. and be able to be ready to start singing at 9 a.m. We'll go from 9 to 12, and then we'll break for lunch. When we come back, we'll be split in two separate rooms, men and women. And then we'll go from there till 5, and then Saturday is over. For those events, and then Saturday night is a peer dance for all the singles and everybody. It's actually for anybody, but we put that on for you singles so that you can get married. That's why we do it. So, amen? So we don't just want princess, we want princess bride, right? And so there you go. So then on Saturday, we have super regional worship services. Okay, so this is exciting. So our super regional worship service will be where it was at last week at the Glendale Hilton. Amen? Amen. And we'll be with AMS again. That's going to be awesome. And we're going to have some more awesome performances. That's going to be great. Now, what's most exciting to me is that Corey Blackwell is going to preach for us. Amen? Yes. And so Corey's going to be preaching. Papa Pat and Pam are going to do communion for us. And then whoever else comes from Chicago will come to our service as well. So we'll have a nice homecoming service in that way. That will be Eric and Jennifer and Clarissa's last Sunday with us. So they'll be moving on to Chicago after that. And stepping up to do the administrative work for Southland is Lisa Davis. So, amen. You know, we figured if she can run a school and oversee a whole bunch of principals, she can run our finances. So there you go. How about that? She'll keep us all straight, you know. And then Nathaniel McCoy is going to be transferring out from here to the South region at the beginning of the year as well. And so, you know, we really do believe that as we mature, we should be able to evangelize where we live. And I don't know if most of you really realize with Nathaniel, he rides the bus here. He rides his bike, and takes the bus, gets on a train, takes the train, rides his bike from the train, all the way from 7th Street in Long Beach. Yeah. He comes all the way up here every midweek, every Sunday. You are an amazing, amazing guy. And so where they meet for church down there is 3 blocks from his house. And so he's going to be a whole lot closer. I'm sure he's going to bear a lot of fruit from being close to where he lives right there. So we're going to miss you a ton. Of course, he's going to wait till Pastor Corey comes and hears his last lesson with him. So, and then he'll be going off after that as well. So, so that's the plan for the new year. And of course, we handed out our calendars. What I want to encourage you to, if everybody can pull out your phone right now. This will be the last announcement. So pull out your phone and pull up a web browser. And go to CAICC.net, right? Okay. So you have the lead cyber evangelist as your leader. So I make sure everybody that I oversee understands what we do in the cyber ministry and why we do all the work that we do. So CAICC.net. So when you get to the web page right there, you'll see you'll have a menu at the top. On the menu is calendar. Okay. So when you go to the calendar, you're going to get the 2017 calendar right there. And it'll be a Google Doc on your phone. Now, I wouldn't spend a lot of time printing it and putting it away, because we do have things that shift and change over the year. So if the giving goes down and we have to cut a service, then there will be a service that changes because of that. Sometimes we just have a leader, you know, sends out of the ministry and we have to make a change. And that makes shifts for everybody. So there's things that do happen. So if you want to print it out, that's okay. But I would encourage you, as you plan your week and whatnot, that you go to this calendar and you pull it up. When we edit the calendar, that's what we edit. It's live. The moment we make a change, you see it right there. It's the actual document. And so you can't edit it. But the moment it's edited, every time you pull that up, it's the latest version. Okay? And so we do our best to communicate to everybody when there are changes to it. That's also why it's important to look at the bulletin here, because as things on the main calendar do change, I change them every Saturday night. I go through them and I update this before I print these to hand out to you on Sunday. So right there, be mindful of your calendar. I'd like to encourage all of us in the first D times of the year that you go through the whole calendar for the year. And that in your own personal calendar, you put these events in and have them slated. Right. Typically, an event won't be just canceled. The time may shift. That's why you won't see times on there, because sometimes we'll do it at 6, sometimes we'll do it at 7. When we book the hotels in the different places, sometimes we can't get it exactly when we want to get it. So there's that kind of shifting that goes along. Okay. So be mindful of where the calendar is. Now, also on that top menu is an area that says regions. You have a link to every regional website. There's another one that says local directory. Every phone number for every leader in our church in every region is on that page. So you don't have to, if you have a friend that you want to take to another service or whatnot, you don't have to go around asking everybody what's the phone number of that leader. You can just go there and all the leaders' phone numbers are updated and posted every single week. Amen? Yep. Awesome. And with that, where's our sound crew? Where's our sound? Can you guys all come up here? All right, Keontae, keep recording, but come on up. So let's bring our sound crew up here. All right. And then where's Julie? Julie, come on up here. Talisha, come on up here. Talisha, Richard Cadel, all the ushers, come on up here. All right. And then Hector and Wendy, Noelle and Janice, Juan and Eunice, come on up here. Okay. So, our singers, come on up here.
Amen.
Singers.
Singers. Okay. All right. Come on up. Let's. We probably have to have two rows. Bit taller guys, come around the back. All right, awesome. And then if you're a Kingdom Kids teacher, come on up here.
Hey, Hector. Come on, Hector.
Come on, Shanti, let's go.
Servants.
All right. All right. Come on up, Julie. Come on up, Julie.
I'm a Julie.
All right. Awesome. All right, so every Sunday, every Wednesday, every service we have. Am I missing anybody? Is there anybody that helps with?
Translators.
Translate.
Translation. Mario, come on up here.
Come on.
Mario.
Mario. Mario. What's that? Administrators. Eric, Jen, come on up here. Thank you.
Clarissa.
Come on, guys.
All right. Eric and Jen, Lisa Davis. So every Sunday, we have our worship services. And then every Wednesday, we have our Wednesday services.
Amen.
Counters, come on up here, too, as well.
Counters.
So,
come on,
there you go.
Come on, y'all.
There you go. All right. So, so every week before service starts, all these people come. Or after service ends, they stay and they serve us. They pick up trash for people. They put chairs in order. They set up sound. They count money. They serve God. Out of the goodness of their heart, they serve and serve and serve. And I just wanted to take a moment to recognize all the serving that goes on in our church. You guys are incredible. You're phenomenal. Now, check this out. Now, if you lead a Bible talk, come on up here.
Come on, Bible talk leader.
All right.
Dang.
Okay. Awesome. Now the Bible talk leaders orchestrate food, take their quiet times, turn them into lessons, create Bible discussion, stand in front of people, and publicly speak every week. You know, remember in your school, I don't like speaking publicly. And yet all the Bible talk leaders do that. And so all of these individuals serve our church every single week and give their time and their heart and their money. Now, if you're on staff, come on up here.
Come on, staff.
Right. Come on, bro. All right. Now, if you invite people to come to church and you've ever studied the Bible with someone or done a Bible study, come on up here.
Spot,
come on up here. All right. Okay. And if you've ever even just sat in a D time, come on up here.
If you're a chair, come up here.
So, the Bible says that every part of the body is needed. Every part of God's body is needed.
Come on, Ron.
Family is important.
Yeah.
That's why it's important for us to all come to service early. Because everyone's present.
That's right.
And so, in God's family, see, in a denominational church, the preacher is up front, a few people get paid to sing and to do worship, and they do everything, and everybody sits in the audience, and they kick their feet up and criticize how well things are done and how well they're not. In God's family, every member is a part of a service.
Oh, man.
Come on.
And we're a part of the family of God.
Okay.
Come on.
Woo!
And I am you.
Ron, you're so great.
Yeah. I love you all with all of my heart. Thank you for making 2016 awesome.
Come on, guys. The center.
Amen.
You doing the avatar thing? You doing the avatar?
Hold on tight.
Yeah.
Amen.
You'll be leaving us soon. We want you to have the honor of praying for us.
Come on.
Come on,
easy.
Easy.
Come on, easy.
Pass him the mic.
Let's make sure our New Year's celebration on New Year.
Amen.
Let's make sure we go to the New Year's celebrations and not the clubs. Let's bring in the new year with the family of God, with purity and love. I do want to give some guidelines with that. Obviously, no alcohol.
Come on.
Obviously, like cranking awesome music.
Woo!
Okay. But let's get done at an early enough time to get our families and our children home before the crazies get out.
Amen.
Yes.
So let's all be together, but let's all be safe together.
Amen. That's right.
Awesome. With that, Eric's going to pray to close out 2016.
Okay.
Woo!
Come on, baby.
Let us pray. God in heaven.
Yes, sir.
Lord of heaven and earth.
Yes, God.
I lift this up to you, Father. This is such a joyful time. It's also a heartbreak.
Thank you, Jesus.
This is our last time that myself, Jennifer, and Clarissa will be for a ministry service. Lord,
thank you.
It's such a privilege and an honor just to be in this room.
Okay.
The brothers and sisters who come near and far.
Yep.
We all come from different socioeconomic backgrounds. Oh, yeah. And it's your son and his blood that joined us all today.
Yes.
Lord, we really got